There I was, working on my detective novel when I overheard an interview with local mystery writer Kate Marple. She was talking about her new book, The Story of a Detective Agency Feuding with a Rival Detective Agency. Deduction? This bitch is stealing my idea.
Oh, fuck you, you hot bastard!
That he was a hot bastard. A milky one, too. Anyway, she stole my idea. And I'm gonna find out why. I went onto her stupid blog and found out where she lived. How? She posted photos of the view from her writing studio. If she's gonna steal my ideas, she should realize how well I know my landmarks. 1992 shield bag and orienteering champion right here.
Is everything okay with the in-laws?
No sign of her yet. I can't bug the place until she leaves. She must be blogging again. Ray Darcy is talking about matchmaking on his show. So funny. Wait, there she is. Kate Marple. What's she leaving out? Oh, must be close for the Chernobyl children. Yeah, she is quite attractive in an indoorsy sort of way. And she thinks she's the J.K. Rowling of local writers. She's more like the Cecilia Ahern. That was funny. I should record all my thoughts on a real dictaphone instead of the dictaphone that's inside my head.
Went home to get my dictaphone. Hope I didn't miss anything. Shit. Oh, I forgot to bring my lunch.
Thanks, Matt.
Will I drop your dinner down later?
Oh, what is it?
Borscht. A Russian stew.
Is Isabel still sending you over her stupid gay communist recipes?
Yes. It's got beetroot in it.
Ooh, beetroot. Mmm, sounds delightful.
Bobby, no Bobby. 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 Bobby.
Oh, I never tired of hearing that.
Some excitement finally. I thought you might be colluding with Street. Turns out he was just trying to steal her bag of Chernobyl clothes.
You! Nothing for the children! What are you doing? That's not Chernobyl children! Not for you!
A brush! What the? Get out of here!
It's like Nora Batty and Compo in Last of the Summer Wine. I could watch it all day. Note to self, get McGrain and Tennyson and drive a bath down the hill. Ideally in Yorkshire.
Got bored staking his woman out. Lonely too. Phone for company.
Bobo? I missed recreational detective work. Hey, after this, do you want to go out to Smuggler's Cove for a spin?
No, I need to catch this bitch out first.
Did you ever read her book, The Mysterious Night Rubbish? It reminded me so much of our mysteries, but shorter. And unpredictable.
You wouldn't dare catch me reading any of that girly mystery chick lit pap.
In the last one, a man had his willy nailed to a cactus.
Girly mystery chick lit pap.
His willy. It's not going to yield anything until we can bug the place.
Why won't she leave?
Spying on a writer. Why couldn't an acrobat or an orchestra conductor have plagiarized you? This is tedium ad nauseum.
Hey, what did I tell you about using Latin in my car?
Boring as this focus.
What did I tell you about using Latin in my car?
I know, I'm sorry. It's just that
I was excited about old school detective work. I missed bugging things.
Fancy a spin out of Smuggler's Cove after this?
Do I? Do you have ginger ale and ton sandwiches?
Does the quick brown fox jump over the lazy dog?
Shut up about quick brown foxes. Is that her at the window?
I don't know. It could be a tall lamp.
She's staring at us.
It's hard to tell.
You know, I forgot what it was like to be a detective.
Yeah, me too. I forgot what it was like to knack or drink while being a detective.
I bet you're in college.
Yeah.
Lads, this is savage crack.
Did you quit college?
No, I'm just Mitchin. You don't tell me Ma, will ya? Actually, can I stay in your house tonight?
Yep, the hammock's free. And Andrew sent me over these African pyjamas. And you can have them because they're too big for my slender wrist.
Stop beeping on her.
She knows.
Shh. No, it's not her, okay. Mm.
Her books are class, in fairness. I don't know why she'd be stealing ideas off of you. But you got most of your ideas off J.K. Rowling, anyway.
That is bullshit, Janine, and you know it. You think Rowling's got a monopoly on fucking house elves?
I love the Kate Marple book about the Russian spies and the poison. It's so romantic.
My favourite one was the microfilm one. The bit where your man had his knob crucified was class.
Does this woman impale penises in every book?
Wait, you're right. She's on the prowl.
Janine, Tennyson, get ready to put the bugs in place.
How are we supposed to get in there?
She's left her key under the mat. You silly, 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 silly little woman. For every crease and fingerprint you leave, iron it out carefully. A reader of you molting.
Ask them if there's a shrine of me.
Is there a shrine of James Vultour?
No, but there's a picture of Tom Moriarty on the fridge.
That swanky dastard son.
Are you waving at us from the window?
Janine, describe his pencil in the library. Describe his pencil in the library.
What the fuck? Why didn't you tell us you
stabbed? We got distracted by you two waving at us from the window like a royal fucking wedding. Now get out of there quickly!
Remember, as quickly and as quietly as you... She's at the door. She's very slow. Have you escaped?
Tennyson walked us into the hot press. For fuck's sake, Tennyson!
Quickly and quietly. Quickly and quietly.
That was her. She tripped up. Bah.
Okay, so you got the place bugged, but you got no evidence.
We got yogurt.
And now, why do ye have two each, and we don't have any?
Finders keepers.
This borscht is amazing. Mm. I must get the recipe off your mother.
She got it from Isabel.
Ah, the taste of distant love. And is there beetroot in it too?
Mm-hmm. No offence, Vultour, but why would a reputable crime writer like her be stealing ideas off a pleb like you?
Well, that's a fair point.
The cliffhanger in the fifth book was amazing. When the villain returned to the fray to launch war on the heroes, I was a little ball of tension in my hammock.
I don't see why you three can't be more supportive of my writing career, all right? You know, we mightn't be working together anymore, but we're still friends.
Yeah, that's why we helped to break into that woman's house.
Did you steal any of her underwear?
No, why?
Just wondering.
Which one of you little piggies had to dip in, Brett?
Why can't she just audibly rip me off?
Seriously, lads. This is fair heartening that you're still doing detective work.
No, this isn't really detective work.
Just chillaxing in our spare time.
Don't ever fucking use that word again or I will upend ya. It's more detective work than that and I do in college anyway, lads.
What do you do in college, Janine?
Oh, I make my own mysteries. deface college books and steal lunches. And pinholes and free johnnies.
The greatest case I ever solved was probably locating that male runner in the women's mini marathon.
There was a lot of suspects in that one.
Stalking me ex, stolen lunch, sticking out a writer. Lads, we're building up to bigger and better cases. Oh, we should take down Johnny Curran next. That show this town who's back in business.
Look, Janine, one swallow does not make a spring. Do you not listen to old sayings?
I'm taking down a spymaster turned spymaster criminal. It's no case for us, Janine. He employs the most dangerous lady agents in the field to do his bidding. Evil women like Natalie Blaze. And Irene. Do you remember Irene, who we used to do line dance with?
Oh, with the check shirt.
Yeah,
Irene. She was lovely. And then she started working for Johnny Curra and she became evil.
Oh, fierce evil.
Wait. Marple is calling her agent.
Sid, I want to talk to you about Jim Vultour. Oh, God. His writing is just terrible. It's so unimaginative. And the amount of house elves in every chapter. There's no mystery in the slightest. The only real mystery is how he thinks anyone would ever buy this codswallop.
Well, you keep talking, Marple. You keep talking and we'll keep recording you.
Can't believe she's so brazen.
I'm so disappointed. I thought her work was so original.
I'm gonna sue this bitch into oblivion. She just needs to say...
No, I literally stole his idea and turned it into my own better idea.
That is it. I am giving this bitch the confronting of a lifetime.
Why did you have your seatbelt on?
In case we crash. You here for the dogging? Us two.
Jim, I know you know who I am. I know you've been stalking me all day. And I know you stole 6 of my probiotic yogurts.
6?
Do you think I didn't pick up some dick tricks in my time?
I bugged your car this morning.
That was quite obvious.
I have everything you've said and done here, Jim. Everything.
Oh, he was wanking, wasn't he?
How dare you? And as for you, you stole my idea.
I didn't steal your idea. Your idea was about a detective agency that fights a rival detective agency, sue them, and go bankrupt. And there's some house elves.
Oh, there are many house elves.
Jim, you based your stories on VPI, and I based my stories on VPI.
You based your stories on us?
Isn't it obvious? You're my inspiration.
Don McGowan?
That would be you.
No, Lieutenant.
That's you now.
Janice Straw!
Even Tim Couture.
But he doesn't have any glasses.
And he's not a creep. Listen, I'm flattered you like my books. I truly am. I suppose... if you were up for it, maybe you could come in for some tea in Battenberg and I could read you some new chapters from my book.
Yeah!
Even me?
No, Jim. Not you. Not you ever.
See you in a minute, Kate.
And then Janice maced the lousy purple news agent into the face. One solid shanking later and his penis rolled across the floor.
No.
I know.
And what happened next?
And then, Noel Tennant ripped himself from the black bag.
Can I come in, please?
Jim, you need to learn. You should never stalk, threaten, or try and sabotage the work of a successful mystery writer. Maybe if you had the potential to become one, you'd understand this.
Yeah, Jim. Listen to Jim.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, lads. You'll come back out and keep me company, won't you? We're friends, remember? We're friends. Hello? Hey. Hey. Hello?
What time does the dog and stare at?
For fuck's sake.